Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. It feels really weird to actually be sitting in front of a full-on camera because the past couple of sitting down chatty videos I've done, I've actually done on my phone because I'm a basic ass bitch and, you know, procrastinate to the point where I can't even bother to set up a camera and put the memory stick in. And it's very easy to edit on a phone, you know, you have the video there and you can just on iMovie or whatever your preference is and then just upload it. But for this, I thought, why not get my camera, sit down, and record. So, if you haven't guessed by the title, this is kind of a tag, kind of a chatty video, mixed into one. It is the... What did we decide the name was? This video is the 12 best bits of 2019. This is done in collaboration with Keita over at the Planet RoqueSox, I think she's called now, because this girl rebrands. But yes, so it is done in connection with Keita. Keita is such a close friend of mine, even though we've never met. Honestly, I am so glad YouTube brought Keita into my life, even if she does squirt tea out her nose when I make her laugh. Besides the point, Keita is honestly one of the most underrated YouTubers I have ever watched in my life. This girl is just amazing in the content she puts out, and she never takes a break, and honestly has so much admiration because I can barely manage to go 6 months uploading regularly without taking a month hiatus. But either way, let us get into the tag. It is 12 questions long, hence the title, The 12 Best Bits of 2019. So, question number one is, what was my favourite video that I uploaded this year? So, I actually uploaded quite a lot, more or less covers, because that's life. That's what all the people say. Anyway. I was trying to think about it, and Keita is going to tell me off for this, but I'm going to split it into two. I'm going to put my favourite video that I posted was reacting to comments about my face, because going into it, people probably thought, oh, it might be a negative spin because, you know, I am disfigured, pointing out the obvious, you know, the elephant in the room. But it was people actually being very nice about the way I look, which was amazing to me at that time. I was quite low in self-esteem. Not anymore. But yeah, so that is my favourite video that I posted and edited together, like a sit-down chatty video. And if it was a cover that I was choosing, it would be my Love on the Brain cover. I love that song, and the reaction that I got from it, the shares that I got from it on Facebook and Twitter was insane and really helped me kind of break the 30 to 40 views that I normally get on each video. The second question is the favourite video that I have seen this year from anybody in the world. Everybody in the world. And I must admit, I go through stages where I religiously watch YouTube and then times where I just don't bother. I go through stages where I comment on everyone's videos and then I comment on no one's videos. But I must admit, one video that does stick out to me was Jenna Marbles watching TikTok videos, and honestly cried with laughter throughout the entire video because Jenna Marbles has made me laugh for over 10 years, and she just made me howl with laughter that whole night. I actually think I woke my mum up, which is quite bad. But yeah, I love that video, and I love TikTok. TikTok is like an underrated Vine, except Vine was definitely better, but there are some videos that are Vine worthy on TikTok, and they were ones that were in her video, and honestly, just her reaction to them made me laugh more, and I think everyone needs a good laugh. The third question is, what is the favourite video you have seen from the person who tagged you? So I was tagged because we've done this jointly by Keita. My favourite video by Keita was posted 5 months ago on the 10th of July 2019, and it was her video titled 11 Reasons to Keep Going. And although I didn't leave a major comment on this video, it really struck with me because I was going through quite a down period mentally at this point, unbeknownst to her or anyone really, because I don't really share my emotions that much because I like to keep things to myself because I'm a very private person. It's weird having a YouTube channel, I know. But this video came at a really good time. It was out of the blue as well because I didn't expect her to do a video like this. Not that I don't ever think she does videos like this. I think they come sporadically and I wasn't expecting it at that point, and it really helped me in more ways than she probably knows, and for that I want to thank you for that, because it was a pick-me-up that I really needed at that time. Question number four was the favourite film that I've seen this year. I've been to a lot of films this year, Captain Marvel, Endgame. I've watched Charlie's Angels recently. I went and seen Lion King. I went and seen Dumbo. But I must admit, my favourite film that I've seen this year was, hands down, Joker. If he does not get an Oscar for that performance, it is beyond me, because he played that character phenomenally. Having to go on from someone like Heath Ledger, because we're just going to avoid Jared Leto's Joker because it was pointless. He did it in his own way. It was mesmerising, and the film and the plot and everything about it was just amazing. And I have watched it 4 times since. Next question is my favourite song of 2019. This was probably the easiest one because I play this song all the time. It is probably, if it comes on shuffle, I never skip it. And it is by an artist who is so underrated, she deserves more recognition, and I really hope next year she can come into her own and show everyone what she's made of. But it is by an artist called Ray, and it's called Love Me Again. Honestly, that song, for someone who has never been in love, I sing that with a passion. And oh, she just makes such good songs, and they're almost like sad songs, but sad songs that you can dance to, and that to me is iconic. The next question is a favourite TV show that I watched this year. This hands down goes to Unbelievable, which is a Netflix original. It is about a girl who is raped in the middle of the night. Someone breaks into her house and then no one believes her because they leave no DNA evidence, and it is so gripping and so good that I watched it in one day. And for me, it was amazing. Good close runner-up was Don't Fuck With Cats, because that was also crazy, crazy, and I watched that in one day too. Question number 7 is my favourite moment of the year. And for me, this is really easy, and I still, it's annoying because I can't really talk about it, but all I can say is Manchester, April 2019, blew my mind, and I met 11 amazing people in Manchester. And it will forever hold a special place in my heart. Biggest lesson of 2019 is the next question. And I would say the biggest lesson that I learned this year is that you're not gonna please everyone. And you're not gonna say the right thing sometimes, and you are gonna mess up, and that's completely okay. And that was the lesson I learned this year. It doesn't make you any less of a good person if you do mess up or you do say the wrong thing. Mistakes happen. Question number 9 is my biggest accomplishment this year, and my biggest accomplishment happened in January, and it was learning how to swim. It was something I always wanted to do, had never gotten around to doing, and I finally got around to doing it this year and loved it, and it was such a good feeling to know that I'd done something. And coming from someone who was 25 and could not swim a length at all, can now swim multiple lengths is just insane, and I'm so proud of myself that I managed to do it. Question number 10 is my favourite purchase that I have made of this year, and it hands down goes to this tartan jacket. And the reason for this is the fact that I get so many compliments on it whenever I wear it. People want to buy it, people want to know where I got it from, people want to take it from me, and honestly, it's so comfy, it's so lovely, and I just want to wear it all the time. I literally do wear it all the time. So that is my favourite purchase. It was from Top Man. I got it in a sale. It was £15. Boom. Question number 11 is the favourite picture that I have posted this year. I posted a lot of photos. I just did my Instagram best 9, and I posted 81 photos this year. Insane. But my favourite photo I posted this year of myself is this one. And the reason that it's this one is because I think I look absolutely iconic. The last question on this tag is, what am I leaving in 2019? I am leaving my unconfident self, because at the start of the year, I was really not confident. Even though I present myself as being confident, I wasn't. And now, I feel like I truly am, and I truly can say that without lying. And that is amazing to me, and I never thought I would get to this point. So in 2019, I leave my unconfident self. And collectively, can we also leave cancel culture? Thanks. And if anyone watching this wants to do this, then please do it and upload, because I want to hear, and let me know. Tag me in it. Here's to 2020. Bye, guys.